Friends, in this class I am going to discuss with you the third chapter of Vistas. The title of this chapter is Journey to the End of the Earth, which is actually pronounced as Journey to the End of the Earth, as I told in yesterday's class. So let's discuss this chapter in the light of the fact that our Earth is becoming the ailing planet day by day. Geoff Green, a teacher, an environmentalist, takes a group of 52 students to Antarctica. The journey starts at 13.09 degree of equator, which is situated as in Chennai. That time it was called Madras when this story was written, when this essay was written. From there, Geoff Green started this journey with 52 students to the windiest, to the driest, and to the largest continent. And you will be very surprised to know that it took 100 hours to reach that place. He used the car, aeroplane, and ship to reach there. Again, he had to pass 9 time zones, 6 checkpoints, and 3 ecosphere to reach Antarctica. Why this journey been taken by Geoff Green? Because he wanted to show the students, the future generation, the harm which is being done to the Earth, which is being done to the atmosphere, which is being done to the ozone layer, and so on. There is a fact in this chapter that Antarctica, the present day Antarctica, used to be called Gondwana land 650 million years ago. There was no sign of human beings on this earth then. The temperature was hotter than the present day there. And a variety of flora and fauna used to be found there in Antarctica. Slowly, gradually, the place was divided into different countries as it is today. Now the question is, why Geoff Green took 52 students to Antarctica, to that journey which is called Journey to the End of the Earth? As you know, that if any type of harm to the environment, to the Earth, if you want to see, if you want to observe, if you want to analyze, you have to go to the Antarctica. And that's why he takes the difficult journey and he reaches there. And there, the fact again is that the world's 90% ice is found in Antarctica. There are icebergs as large as countries of the world. They keep on breaking every day, every second, every moment. And the largest hole in the ozone layer is to be found there in Antarctica. The world is going very fast to be submerged in water. But we are unaware of this fact and we keep on increasing the level of carbon dioxide in the air. And as you know that this gas is very harmful for human being. And it is the major cause of global warming. Because you may have studied in your school books that the carbon dioxide gas has the quality of trapping the heat of the sun. It traps the heat of the sun and it does not let it go away in the atmosphere back. And that's why the temperature of the earth is increasing day by day, day by day, which leads to global warming. As soon as human being came into the limelight, came into the ring, then he started exploiting the natural resources. And he started exploiting the natural resources recklessly without a second thought of the future generation, of the upcoming generation. Human being, even in 2020, he doesn't think about the notion of coexistence. He keeps on exploiting the natural resources like as if it's only be for them. It's only for their use, and it will not come to an end anytime. That's why they are using it like anything. But the fact is that the non-renewable resources of energy will exhaust someday if it is used recklessly, if it is used wiselessly. And human being who thinks himself the master of this earth, the owner of this earth, he doesn't think of the consequences which will occur after they get exhausted, after the natural resources get exhausted. The question of global warming has arrived in this chapter to the extent that human being has caused not only global warming but acid rain also. As you know, that in the air, the concentration of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and methane increasing very, very high. It's there in the very high level, at the very high degree, they are increasing. These gases are increasing in the air at a very fast pace, at a very fast rate. And as you know, that when acid rain forms only when the rainwater is mixed with sulfur dioxide, the rain becomes acid rain. The water becomes acidic. And when this rainfall pour down over the statue of marble or buildings of marble, it is eroded. The whiteness gone. And instead of that, you may find sour cream color of the marble. Means yellowish color of the marble you may find. It's only because of this acid rain. And you will also find that the marble buildings, the buildings made of marble, the statues made of marble, and the other structures made of marble, they get eroded. The quality of marble degrades day by day, because of this acidic rain. And if we talk about the global warming, the major reason of this is the depletion in the ozone layer. And why does this depletion occur? It's only because of the use of aerosol chemicals, the CFCs, increase of CFCs, that is chlorofluorocarbons, in the atmosphere. These chemicals react with the ozone layer and it causes its depletion. It's caused its depletion. What happens, let me tell you, that as you know, that symbol of ozone is O3 and that of oxygen is O2. When O3 is react with CFC, it gives out O2 and one atom of oxygen goes into the atmosphere. So O3 becomes O2. Means ozone becomes oxygen, and that's why the direct sunlight fall onto the earth and which causes skin cancer, which causes a number of problems related to your eyes, related to your skin, and the earth is becoming warmer again and again. And if you have to see this depletion, if you have to observe this depletion through your eyes, you have to go to Antarctica, and this is why Geoff Green took a group of 52 students to Antarctica. This is the only reason. Now, the question arises also that why Geoff Green wants to show these children the condition of the earth in the present time. The only reason is that the students who are young, who are dynamic, who can understand the things, They may make people aware regarding the depletion of the earth, regarding the global warming, regarding the depletion in the ozone layer, and so on. When we talk about global warming, when we talk about that the earth will submerge into water, we are not able to understand the seriousness of this matter. But when you go to the Antarctica and when you see, when you watch through your own eyes that icebergs are melting like anything, that icebergs are melting at a very fast rate, we will think about the terror which will run through our mind, which will run through our mind that, oh, it will take very less time that the whole earth will submerge into water. That there will be flood everywhere and the life will not exist on this earth. This is the fact which is being told in this chapter by Tishani Doshi. In the next class, I'll discuss the rest of the things of this chapter. Please go through this lecture again and again and try to write out the summary. Thank you very much.